Appreciate the opportunity to present to the community here. Quite exciting. So just a little bit about ourselves here. We're a team of three MVPs, and we're located around the world. I'm actually in New Haven, Missouri, which is the wine district of Missouri, as you can see. I'm also a Scottish small pipes player, so like to sip some wine and play some pipes. Work with Covenant Technology Partners as a principal architect, again, co-pilot MVP. We have Knut here, who is located in Oslo, and he has an affinity for trolls, as you can see, very involved in collab days there in Northern Europe. And then finally, we have Martin, who is located in Hamburg. So again, a team of three MVPs. We enjoy being and working with one another, but we are able to work remotely. So we really enjoyed working on this submission, and so quickly we'll just jump right into it. So in terms of describing the project, what we thought we would do is take a scenario, a business challenge, of a fictitious construction company that we've called Dustro. And the idea here is that this company is having some challenges around identifying employees with certain skill sets to work out in the construction field. So they do lots of build and repair around concrete and foundations, carpentry, and so on and so forth. The challenge is that the construction foremen who are out in the field cannot always find the right people to select to work on the projects. So in our particular scenario here, what we have is we have an application that will allow us to give the foreman an ability to select individuals who can meet their criteria. This is a quick overview of the architecture, and we'll just look at the top here, start at the top. We start with a construction worker who actually fills out a skills assessment form in Microsoft Forms. And what we do is we run a Power Automate script, which converts the forms input into a PDF, which allows us then to use agents to search that information through through generative AI prompts. So we do have a built-in SharePoint skills agent that's available to the info workers through the SharePoint portal. But the real sauce here is around the construction foreman here. You can see the foreman has a skill request form that they can fill out. And what this does is it triggers an autonomous agent, which then between Power Automate and Copilot Studio and ChatGPT and so forth here, we'll run through and actually pull the information out and email the response to the construction foreman. So just some real quick context here. We have a, this is the image of our internet portal here. As you can see, this is what the information workers would use to go in and interact with the portal. This is an example of the skill assessment form that each employee would fill out. And so the idea is that they would put in their name and their different skill ranges. They would rate themselves as either beginner, intermediate, or experienced based on one or more skill areas. And then the Power Automate script, as I mentioned, will convert the form information into a PDF. The reason why we did this was because SharePoint Lists was not available at the time to be used by Copilot. And so we decided to just generate the forms in PDF, and that allows the agents to pull that information. And then this is an example of the form that the foreman would use. Again, they put in their name and title or email address. And then the skills request, again, that they're looking for, the skills required is entered in the form of a prompt or a request. So in this example, they're looking for employees with expert level skills in trenching, for example. This is just a diagram to show what we're doing here in Copilot Studio, and I'll go into more detail on that in just a minute, but we are using generative orchestration for that. And as many of you know, the orchestrator has different trigger points that are available within Copilot Studio, and the orchestrator will create a plan, you know, based on the information that's put into the agent. Ultimately, the life cycle will produce the ability to hook into a trigger down here in the lower right to pull the generated response. This allows us to actually consult the response or evaluate the response before it's actually submitted, either through a conversational interface or something else is done with it. And we're going to be doing a little bit of work around some table formatting. And so we'll show that in a minute. All right, I'm going to jump into the demo real quick here. So again, this is the intranet site I showed you here in PowerPoint. Nothing real new or interesting here, except we obviously did a lot with regards to using some of the new features in SharePoint. This is the skill assessment form that I talked about here earlier. Again, it's just a form available off a link, can be filled out by the employees as a self-assess. And then we also have the PDF that gets generated from the form. So as you can see here, it's just a straightforward PDF. What we've done is we laid out the information by a different skill category, and we've listed what the skill level is, you know, advanced, intermediate, expert, and so forth here. And this is what Copilot then will be using to evaluate. This is just an example. We do have a SharePoint agent that's attached to the SharePoint site. This allows info workers to be able to run queries just using a straight conversational interface here. And then finally, this is the skill request form that is used by the foreman to be able to go out and request the information here. And again, in this example, we've got John Smith, who's a foreman with his email address, and he's saying he needs an employee with expert foundation skills. All right, we're now going to pivot into the Copilot Studio agent itself and talk about how we kind of put this thing together. So first of all, as I mentioned, we are using generative orchestration. Again, just running through the overview of the agent here, you can see that we are using the employee skill profile as a knowledge source. This is just that document library that's in SharePoint, which is up in here. Let me just pull that up for you real quick. Again, it's just the document library here that has all the profiles in PDF. So this here is the knowledge source here. Again, we just got some PDF files out here. And then what we've got is we've got the different components of the agent here is we have a trigger. And a trigger is going to be executed for this autonomous agent based on a form response that's submitted. Now, this is the skill request form that the foreman is going to fill out. And so it's going to run this particular trigger. And the trigger, when it's executed, will actually run this Power Automate script here. So all we're doing here is we're just simply listening in for a new response form based on that skill request form. And then what we're doing here is we're going through and we're actually pulling out the, we're pulling out a particular variable here, which is the actual description of the skill that's required. So even though we have the entire body available for us, what we really want to do is just send the one variable off the form that's the actual skill request into Copilot. So in this last action here, we're sending that prompt then into Copilot, the generative orchestrator, for processing. Okay, then the next step here is we are going to be tying into the, through topics, we're going to be tying into that generative orchestration lifecycle. And here what we're doing is we're going in and we're looking at, as you can see, the AI response generated. This is triggered by the orchestrator automatically. So this topic is going to fire based on this trigger. And all we're doing is we're pulling the response in through input variables, and we're applying another generative AI prompt against the result coming in. So what I'm saying here is, hey, take the input that has come in and format it into a table format in HTML for use in an Outlook email. Only include the table and no other text. So what we're doing is the generative response coming back, we're saying, hey, we really want you to reformat this into a table format, OK? Okay. And I've just got a couple of debug messages here. And then we want to actually take that response, the table format response, and then we have an agent flow here within this action. Okay, and I'll pull that up here. The agent flow is very straightforward. All it's really doing is it's taking the input that's come in from the prompt response here, and it's just sending that in through a body in an email. Okay, pretty straightforward. All right, so let's quickly just run a quick test so you can see this in action. And I think that will pretty much finish it off. So I'm gonna just go in and I'm gonna test the trigger. I've already submitted a form, so I'm just going to take an existing form submission here to start testing. And as you can see in the side panel, the test panel here, it's actually, you know, running the trigger, processing it. And then now it's kicking off the process response topic, which is based on that AI response generated from the orchestrator, okay? And then finally, we're sending off the email to the fictitious format, basically, okay? So as you can see, we've completed all the steps. So what I should see now is an email. And there it is. And you can see it's taken the results of the individuals who have the foundation. In this case, I was asking for foundation skill, right? Expert level. It's giving me the link back to the source here, and it's formatted this into a table. And that's it. That's what we got. Do we have any questions?
Really, really cool stuff. Yeah, I don't see. There's a few questions in the chat, which I'll let you go ahead and let me see. We've got about a minute if you want to. One of the questions is, with so many passive implementation, what should be the starting point piloting new applications, and what criteria you use to decide which tasks and processes to prioritize?
Well, I think that's probably a business question, maybe a business ROI question, if I'm understanding it correctly. So, you know, the idea, of course, is that most businesses are grappling with AI, you know, trying to figure this thing out, right? And while they know they need to do something, many of them are afraid to do something. They're fearful to do something, they're fearful not to do something. So the idea is to come in and help them understand where their biggest business challenges are. And in this particular fictitious case, right, their challenge is being able to match skills to work, right? And so maybe just start with a POC, right? Like what I've done here, just a quick proof of concept, showing them the art of the possible, and then allow them then to measure that ROI,